Today, I'm going to show you how to add a stamp effect to your logo design or even your name in Adobe Illustrator, and it's going to be a vector design. Also, towards the very end of this video, I have a very cool announcement to make. And remember, you can move to the time card in the corner if you want to skip the intro. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So I'm finally back from my travels, and I hope you guys had a great weekend. Towards the very end of today's Illustrator tutorial, I have a cool announcement to make, so be sure to stay around for that. You can use this tutorial on a logo design you've made, or even some text or typography, so for example your name. Today, however, I'm going to use my Satori Graphics logo design as the example. If you use text, make sure that you outline the type before by going up to Type and Create Outlines. The first thing you need to do is to open up the Pathfinder window in Adobe Illustrator, and then unite every single part of your design as one. Now that you've knitted everything together, grab the ellipse tool and create a perfect circle by holding down shift and clicking and dragging. You need to then bring up your logo or your text to the very front and then place the logo or your text on top of the circle. I'm going to use the eyedropper tool to sample white from the background onto my logo. We need to use the Pathfinder tool again, so open it up, and then select the circle and the logo together, and then use the minus front option. This will cut the logo into the circle, so now you have one object for your stamp effect in Illustrator. As you can see, my logo is now cut into the circle, and that's exactly what we want. We're going to make another circle, but this time we only want to use a stroke rather than a fill. Place the circle around the design and then resize it. You can now select both circles and align them like I'm doing here. For the outermost circle, you can increase the weight until you're happy with how it looks with your stamp effect. As you can see, I've moved my thick outer circle closer to the logo and the stamp part of the design, and the thin circle is on the outside. Now you need to take the scissors tool and click once on each side of the circle like I'm doing here. This cuts the circle into two parts essentially. Hold down and click over the type tool, and then select type on a path tool. Click the top part of the circle, and then type in some text that's relevant to your stamp logo design. I find a thicker sans serif font works best for this type of design. You can bring up the type window here to customize your text more efficiently. When you're done adjusting your text, take the direct selection tool and then locate the small line on the circle to drag the text around like I'm doing here. You can hit Command or Control R to open up your rulers, and then drag down a guide to align your text perfectly. Now we can add some text on the bottom half with the same method as before. However, the only difference is that the text type's upside down. So to flip it back over, Watch as I use the direct selection tool and click and drag in the correct place. Go ahead and adjust your text spacing and placing. As you can see here, I've moved a thicker line on the outside and I've changed my font. You can just use whatever you feel is best for your stamp logo design. Also, as I'm doing here, go ahead and use the guides to make sure everything is perfectly aligned. We're now ready to add the actual stamp effect to our design in Adobe Illustrator. You can use the align window to align the circles as I'm doing here. But once you're happy, select everything and then outline the stroke of your design, as well as creating the outlines of the type. Again, in the Pathfinder window, unite everything into one object. For the stamp effect, we're going to need to open up the transparency window. Also, you will need to open up the grunge vectors, which I've linked in the description below. These vectors can make your computer slow, as there are many different objects that make them up. So to make things easier, which I forgot to do in the tutorial, select one of the vectors that you want to use, and then unite everything as one object in the Pathfinder window. Hit Command or Control C to copy the grunge vector, and then go back to your stamp logo design. In the transparency window, with the logo selected, click Make Mask, and then uncheck Clip. Then select the right-hand window and hit Command or Control V to paste the vector in place. You can now use Shift to adjust and resize the vector. Click the left window in the transparency window to select off of the mask. You can now add color to your stamp logo effect. Red is often the cliche color of choice, but blue works also. You can add multiple vector layers on the transparency mask layer, adding more of a stamp effect. So there was my Illustrator tutorial on how to add a stamp effect to your logo or your text. The announcement I have today for you guys is that I finally finished my ebook, which is a typography guide for beginners. It has typography tips, definitions, and terminologies, and it's all presented in a very artistic and graphic manner. I don't think there's anything else like it out there. So if you want to download it, head over to my website www.satorigraphics.net, and it's on sale for the next 24 hours only, half price, down from $2.70. So check it out if you're interested in typography or if you want to help out my channel. Subscribe for 4 weekly graphic design uploads, and like and share my content if you really do enjoy it. So until next time, design your future today. Peace.